Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Amen. Behold, I create new heavens and a new earth, and the former things shall not be remembered or come into mind. But be glad and rejoice forever in that which I create. For behold, I create Jerusalem to be a joy, and her people to be a gladness. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and be glad in my people. No more shall be heard in the sound of weeping and the cry of distress. No more shall there be in it an infant who lives but a few days, or an old man who does not fill out his days. For the young man shall die 100 years old, and the sinner 100 years old shall be accursed. They shall build houses and inhabit them, they shall plant vineyards and eat their fruit. They shall not build and another inhabit, they shall not plant and another eat. For like the days of the tree shall be the days like what my people be, and my chosen shall long enjoy the work of their hands. They shall not labor in vain or bear children for calamity, for they shall be the offspring of the blessed one of the Lord, and their descendants with them. Before they call, I will answer. While they are yet speaking, I will hear. The wolf and the lamb shall graze together. The lion shall eat straw like the ox, and dust shall be the serpent's food. They shall not hurt or destroy in all my holy mountain, says the Lord. Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
On Alleluia. The epistle is from 1 Corinthians 15. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For as by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as a man all died, so also in Christ shall all be made alive, but each in his own order. Christ the first fruits. Then at his coming those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he delivers the kingdom to God and the Father, after destroying every rule and every authority and power. And he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to destroy is death. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
And as they were frightened and bowed their faces to the ground, the men said to them, Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified and on the third day rise. And they remembered his words. Returning from the tomb, they told all these things to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna, Mary the mother of James, and the other women with him who told these things to the apostles. But these words seemed to them like an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter rose and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen cloths by themselves. He went home marveling at what had happened. Hallelujah! Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Whatever carpet you drew on, and
maybe something paper a little later on. And of course, the wire thing, I think the tension was thing. And I remember Easter bunnies, chocolate Easter bunnies. The solid ones, yes. And the hollow ones, okay. Sort of the opposite of the resurrection, right? If the tomb was full, okay. But the tomb is empty. Hallelujah.
What does baptizing with water signify? It signifies that the old Adam in us carefully, by daily contrition and repentance, should die with all sins and evil desires, and again, a new man daily emerge and arise, through this word there is Auferstehung, resurrection. Every day, you are resurrected to live before God in righteousness and purity forever. The beautiful thing that is. And every day we stand before our Lord and we say, Lord, have mercy on me. We are not worthy to come into your presence. But for the sake of your Son, forgive my sins, which are many and habitual and overwhelming. Sometimes we feel it. The guilt of our sin weighs us down and drags us back. We can feel like it's a kind of living death. When the absolution reaches your ears and you realize what that really means, that God has taken that away from you and gotten rid of it, it is, like a new life, it is a new life. Granted to you every day. In a sense, everything is at least, including this. Easter to come. You can't turn anywhere in the Bible without finding that promise, including our epistle reading for today, that because Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, he has become the first fruits of those that have fallen asleep, including your loved ones who have died in him. He says, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he dies, he shall live. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. He says, on the last day that we return, great power and glory with his holy angels. He will judge the living and the dead. Those who are bogus, those who do not trust in him, those who do not believe in him, are sent into everlasting condemnation. What about those who believe, the sheep who are his, who he calls by name, who rise to everlasting life? And what a life that we believe. Not as the pagans who believe in a sort of half-life after death, but we are spirits who either go into some nether world or really good Elysian fields. We are not like our forefather pagan Germans who thought there was a Valhalla where the mightiest and best heroes go till the end of their own story. We actually are linked to human history. And that history, resurrection of Jesus Christ in time, in history, is the assurance that you will rise bodily, will be made perfect. So, one of the things I'm looking forward to is I'm going to be able to look out your eyes and be able to see that instead. Maybe some of you will bet. I'll be able to hear what you say instead of going, And all the infirmities that point us to God, we will be as God intended us to be. We will enjoy his presence forever in the presence of one another. What a fantastic thing that is. Now, today we hold these things by faith. We don't see them. We walk by faith and not by sight. We take the promise that God gives us and we say, I'm going to cling to that in spite of what my own fuzzy eyes may see and my old corrupt ears may hear. I'm going to trust that. This promise to us is those who trust. Going to see that it is so. And that is the great promise of Easter. I am the resurrection and the life, it says. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, and the middle, and all things. So you are right this day to say hallelujah and praise to the Lord our God. You'll be right in the last day when your faith in Jesus Christ will be justified. Shown to be right. So Easter, past, present, and future is all one in Christ Jesus. God grant that resurrection may animate you this day and throughout your life. The peace of God that passes all understanding will keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Here to page 11 of the musical offering.
Thank you.
Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered in his spirit, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge all the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. I believe in the one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray. For God, this Easter day, fill your people with holy fear of the resurrection of your Son, that we would no longer tremble before the grave, but rejoice and live in the truth of your victory, Lord. Let us hold fast to the words preached to us, that receiving it with joy, we may take our stand in it and be saved by it. Hinder all who would so doubt, grant us courage to confess its truth. Bless all who make and administer our laws, frustrate the forces of evil. Grant peace here and throughout the world. Guard our armed forces, watch over our law enforcement officers and first responders as they stand watch for us, protect us at both home and abroad. Have mercy on the sick and those in need, especially Kathy Raymond, John Odette Thomas, Nancy, Cindy, Marilyn, Tom, Sharon, Missy, Don, Renee, Emily, Bernadette, Inez, Keith, Dan, George and Bonnie, and Billy. With the light of the new creation in Christ, sustain them in faith, according to your will, grant them renewed health and a foretaste of their eternal healing in Him. Comfort those who mourn with the truth of Christ's empty tomb, that in the midst of their grief they may abide in the hope of His resurrection. Give us joy in your Son's great feast, as he shares it with us from this altar. In the eating of his body and his drinking of his blood, swallow up our death in his life, so that we may be glad and rejoice in his salvation. We join in our glorious with angels, with the assembly of the firstborn enrolled in heaven, and with the spirits of the righteous made perfect, and bring our petitions before you, dear Father, trusting in your mercy. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The service of the sacrament is on page 160. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. The very Paschal Lamb who was sacrificed for us and bore the sins of the world. By his dying, he has destroyed death, and by his rising again, he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with Mary Magdalene, Peter and John, and with all the witnesses of the resurrection, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we long to magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. To you, O Father, be all glory, honor, and worship, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks and broken it, he gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
us to the same, in faith for you and in fervent love for one another. In Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.